going to work. We have to take down the Lord Regent and all of his key allies.
All citizens living on the north side of the river between
Hopefully
John
the High Overseer is the first
and Dunwall Tower are advised
and we must
to
find
remain indoors until further notice.
Perfect. You did it! Somehow you took down the High Overseer Campbell against the odds. I knew you were our man, Corwo. With Campbell gone, we've hurt the Lord Regent immeasurably. And with Martin back, we'll have the finest strategist alive.
The Lord Regent must be shitting himself in Dunwall Tower.
Yes, and Campbell's journal, let's not forget. Our hope is that in these encoded pages, the location and condition of Emily Caldwin can be discovered. Our entire movement will mean nothing if we can't place the rightful heir on the throne. We must act fast. No doubt the Lord Regent is holding Emily somewhere, waiting to reveal her, to step out as the hero and further cement his regency.
If he doesn't bring the young lady forth soon, there'll be infighting among the nobles as to who should succeed the Empress.
Yes, time is against us. But now you should take a well-earned rest, Corvo. We will decipher the contents of the High Overseer's journal and share them with you later.
As yet, I have said little of my brothers Morgan and Custis. Twins they are, 4 years seen. Morgan is the larger of the two brothers by the slightest. From earliest memory, they have been seen as well. I'm not the first to fight. They were cruel. But my suffering was unique. I promise.
You're lucky I keep you on.
It is every citizen's duty.
This place would fall apart in 10 minutes without me.
And actions.
Is that so?
Depends on you.
In any case, you can't dismiss me. I went through the books this morning and found 5 mistakes you've made.
Very well.
I have kicked a few serpents to
You're
a pulp
lucky
and others have slithered away. But not before I've been bitten a dozen times or more on my legs. The wounds kept me convalescent.
I know the golden cat. Not as a patron.
Hello, Corvo. I expect Martin will be joining us shortly. I hate to start your day with such a strange matter, but the servants heard something last night, moving through the storm drains beneath the building. Most likely a weeper, the poor bastard. There's no hope for them once the plague gets that far along. Nothing more than a shuffling corpse full of sickness and insects, if you ask me. I'd appreciate you investigating, just to be sure it's not a nosy guardsman that's getting too close. Here's a key to the hatches. I'd send a servant down there, but they'd die of fear on the spot, I'm afraid. Maybe Piero can concoct some sort of sleep poison for your crossbow if you want to go that route.
Thank you. You went down there in the sewers? I thought I heard a weeper in there earlier. You're probably the bravest man I've ever met. Overseer Martin has arrived. He's with Admiral Havelock now. They want to talk to you.
Corvo, I trust you remember Martin, an overseer before, and perhaps again someday soon.
I owe you thanks for my rescue.
Indeed. You've given us a glimmer of hope, Corvo. Because we've gotten what we wanted from Campbell's journal. You've done it. We know where Emily Caldwin is being held.
The Golden Cat, of all places. A bathhouse for aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. The twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes we so desperately need.
Yes, the Pendletons have to die. But most importantly, Emily must be brought here safely so we can protect her until the Lord Regent and his entourage have been dealt with. Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally.
Corvo, a moment if I may. Ah, the Royal Protector. Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis. They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard, cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent, and as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to stop the Lord Regent from further consolidating his power. These days, they're best known for exploiting their favor with him to cheat others out of their wealth. Let's just say that not every family evicted in quarantine for having the plague actually has the plague. I warned my brothers in every way I could. I really did. But they never did listen to me. They'll be at the Golden Cat tonight at their usual revels. They'll be protected by the city watch, so it'll be dangerous. Now go. Please do it before I change my mind.
Corvo, my friend. Do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
I'll take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me. I'll get you as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat, if he don't kill you. This here's his territory. He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you're bringing back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo. The river hand on your...
Just the man I's looking for.
Slackjaw's wanting to talk to you.
Come out, and I'll go easy on you.
Shit, someone's dead. I'll find you.
whiskey and cigars tonight? Indeed, I believe so.
I say, we take the fight to them.
There's no proof.
The rats are...
They're still just rats.
Just rats? Rats that can strip a corpse to death in seconds. That's from the continent. I got a cousin, a traitor. Said he saw shit like that, and much, much worse.
Even if you're right, what do we do?
Send a fleet to the continent. Burn the whole country down. That'd show.
Wages, are they serious?
Where did Morgan go? I've lost track of him again.
Morgan's in the steam room downstairs tonight.
Is it safe in there? Because I've heard rumors. If one of them gets hurt, I'll lose my job.
Oh, that's just the girls talking. It's nothing. Pressure builds up in the pipes and, well, it almost never happens. I'll make sure they never mention it again. Anyhow, Morgan insisted to be in the steam room tonight. He's so picky. Custis is easier to manage. Some... Grumman talks to a girl. It's funny what people will pay for.
Thank you. that nice girl again. The one I told you about.
You realize you're at the Golden Cat, right?
Yeah, but she's different. She really likes me.
Idiot. She likes your money, not you.
You're just jealous.
Pendletons are here. You're supposed to be on duty.
Come on.
You're supposed to be on guard. You'll get dismissed for sure. I can't believe it.
Listen, you said you weren't even drunk. Wake up.
Morgan will be in there all night.
More coin for us. Though we'd make even more if they didn't blow it on prostitutes.
My cousin, foreman at their mine. He says the slaves have dug half a mile down, so deep they're dying by the dozen from collapse or fumes. But the silver's almost gone.
What are they going to do?
Looks like they're gonna gamble and drink every night. Till it's gone, then jump in the river. They state that the conservative position gets an extra 3 votes.
But not in the month of timber.
Is that true? How on earth do you know that?
Did you think I was born a courtesan, Lord Pendleton? I was a clerk, Lord Estermont, before.
Whatever happened to old Estermont?
The rats did. An old sewer line led under his office in Parliament, and one day it flooded, and they all came rushing out. They say...
What is that noise?
Oh, no. No, no, no!
Spread out. There's been word of a ruckus. No details yet.
have you put down.
Now, the stupid goddamn devil son of a gun. No!
We know you're here. We'll find you.
He's slippery.
Check everything.
I'll flush you out.
There's been a murder here at the cat. Unbelievable.
Search the area.
Who are you? Why are you wearing that mask? Corvo? Corvo, it's you! You're wearing a mask to sneak around, aren't you? They told me you were head chopped off in the prison, dead, like Mother. That seems like a long time ago. But you're not dead. Now we can leave. I have a plan. I almost got away twice. There's a special door to come and go, for special people, and I'll show you. And if anyone tries to stop us, you can fight them. It's this way.
Have you seen it?
Check under everything.
Feed for you.
Probably rats into everything.
They'll do what Granny says. I hear them laughing, but they'll see what I can do.
Dunwall citizens, a mandatory whale oil ration is now in effect. Non-compliance is a punishable offense.
Want to look at some of the things I've found? Good prices, I swear.
What a mess, huh? Whole town's gone to trash.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Anyone with information pertaining to the death?
Ready to go back, Corvo? You made short work of things. Get in. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, Our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention.